Good evening. It was 90 minutes of mayhem for 60 kilometres across Sydney, leaving a trail of destruction from Campbelltown to Arncliff. An innocent driver was stabbed, a dozen vehicles rammed, a police officer bitten, and the man behind it all, Ryan John Harris, shot in the leg. Tonight, only Nine News can bring you the terrifying pictures of the entire ordeal.
A stolen Subaru, reported as driving dangerously, slips into this Narellan service station. But police are seconds behind. Officers, with their weapons drawn, demand those inside surrender. But Ryan John Harris isn't listening. He rams the police car over and over, then runs, pulling a machete from his backpack, but trips at the service station doors. He's trying to escape, attempting to get into one car. Then he goes for a second. The owner, realising he's armed, bolts. Harris starts to run as well from police, who fire two shots, one hitting him in the leg. But Harris is gone, stealing a car, and he drives it to this intersection in Appin. With a bullet in his leg, he limps to this White Holden. In a scuffle, he stabs the driver in the neck, gets inside and speeds off. But what he doesn't realise is the dash cam is recording everything that happens next.
Huh? What?
You are seeing inside a stolen car. It's November 2020, the video released by a court to Nine News after Harris was found guilty. He's under the influence of ice behind the wheel. He swerves onto the wrong side of Appin Road in Rosemeadow and starts talking to himself.
I had to throw me machete and all, they shot me. The coppers shot me.
Dodges trucks, runs red lights and even hits innocent road users as he speeds through Campbelltown.
I stabbed someone in the neck in his car.
A 20-minute drive through Cashula, Reevesby and Riverwood. He's trying to reach the airport. Finally, in Arncliff, the reality of the situation finally hits home. Inside the M5 tunnel, he stops driving, backs up and pulls over. Police have him cornered, but he doesn't go quietly. Officers crawling over the vehicle, police dog Chief is the first in the car and gets stabbed with a screwdriver. Two officers jump in, one of them is bitten by Harris, who's eventually arrested and handcuffed. The end of a rampage. Police officers and innocent members of the public injured. Four stolen cars. But tonight, the man responsible is behind bars. Alex Heineke, Nine News.
Ryan John Harris was found guilty a little over a week ago on 11 charges relating to the rampage. It's taken nearly 3 years for the judgment to be handed down because of several mental health issues raised in court. Harris will learn how long he'll spend behind bars, Pete, in October.
Alex, thank you.